Hello, this is David Kettlewell, and welcome to Medical Matters Because Life Matters. Today is a fascinating show for me, and I'm sure for you as well. We're going to be talking about the latest in imaging techniques and quite a bit about breast cancer treatment as well. So thanks for joining us. Hello. I'd like to introduce you to our guests. We have with us from Winsong Radiology, first, Anna Chen Dio. Hello.
Hi.
And we have Dr. Raja Cheravu.
Good morning.
And also Dr. Anthony Foti.
Hello.
Anna, let's start with you. I don't think that there is a topic which is of more emotionally charged for women than breast cancer. As you've told me before the show, about 1 in 7 women in their lifetime are going to have breast cancer of some type. And what you do with the testing that you do is to really get to the head of trying to really help these women and make sure that you catch whatever's going on early. Introduce us to the topic of mammograms, if you could.
Well, mammography has been the gold standard of imaging for detection of breast cancer. There are many new imaging technologies that are coming out and are emerging to help in detection of breast cancer early. However, mammography has remained the standard, the gold standard imaging that has been proven time after time to decrease the morbidity and mortality of breast cancer in women.
Now, when we say a mammogram, what does that mean?
A mammogram is a low-dose x-ray that is taken of a woman's breast. Her breast is compressed between two plates on a machine, and it takes an image of the internal structures of the breast tissue. Now we have what we call digital mammography, which is been studied and shown to help detect breast cancer with better contrast imaging than the traditional film screen mammography, which is the x-ray.
How does the technology work?
Well, what happens is, to the patient, it really is no different from our conventional mammogram. Mm-hmm. To the patient, it is taken in the exact same way as our traditional mammograms. However, instead of being the x-rays to be placed on a film where it needs to be processed in a machine, we have a computer that sends, that produces an image of the breast and can send it directly over to our monitor so the radiologist can view it immediately.
A lot of our viewers may not be aware of why it is that radiology has been carved out as a specialty in medicine, and of course this relates to what is Winsong Radiology. So if you could talk with me a little bit, all of you if you'd like, about how this got carved out as a specialty, and then what is Winsong Radiology?
Well, radiology is a specialty because there's so many different emerging technologies coming out that there needs to be a specialist that can keep on top of that. And we do so much extensive training in terms of the different imaging things that we need to know that's how it has become a specialty.
I know that I've had many physician friends, and they'll get a radiograph in and they'll go, I can't read this. I need to call and have somebody else read this, you know. So it's very, very common that you have a specialist that actually looks for things very carefully. Did you have any comment about this area of breaking out?
Well, you want your physician, your primary care physician, or say your orthopedic surgeon, to know everything they can know about their specialty, about how to operate or how to take care of patients' hypertension. It's a lot to ask them to also know the detailed anatomy that you'd see on a CT scan, and whether you'd get a CT scan or an MRI or just an x-ray, and when you get those different modalities, and how to protocol the scan properly, and how to take the right images. So it's really, it would be too much to ask any one physician to do all that. So instead, they turn to the subspecialties, just like your primary care doctor wouldn't operate on your brain, and your orthopedic surgeon wouldn't operate on your liver. You have liver specialists and orthopedic surgeons and all these different specialties. Radiology is just like that. Our job is to image, make a diagnosis, or direct therapy, and then we let the specialists take care of the patient from there.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Cheravu?
Yeah, I mean, as Anna alluded to, imaging is a constantly changing field, and just as you have changes in computer technology, you have a great number of changes in imaging technology, and for your average physician to keep on top of that would be quite difficult.
So what differentiates Winsong Radiology from others in this area? I'm just curious.
Well, we pride ourselves in being up to date on the most advanced imaging technology and getting and allowing us to provide that to the community. We were the first to provide digital mammography to the community, and now we also provide breast MRI. We are one of the only facilities in the area that provides breast MRI guided biopsies.
Okay, let's get back a little bit more into the work you do with diagnostic mammography. If you could go into a little bit more detail for me on the digital mammography and what it's like as a professional, a physician, for you to work with the images that you're looking at. Do you have the ability in the computer to change them and make different things show up more clearly? What's the advantage to you of using this new digital technology?
The advantage to us is digital mammography, first for the patient, is that it makes their wait time significantly decreased because we're not waiting for the films to be processed. We get to view these images immediately.
Just like today's cameras, if you want to take a picture with a digital camera.
Exactly.
And you can look at it right then.
Exactly.
Okay.
The other advantage for us as radiologists is that we get to manipulate the image. We get to play with the images on our computer to help with the contrast. If we don't see something as well, in the past we used to have to take more pictures. Now, with the ability to manipulate our images, we can adjust images to help us see through certain things. We still may need more pictures, but at least it will decrease the number of images that we have to take.
I have a family that I'm close friends with from Italy, and the one fella, Guido, grew up in southern Italy on a farm and came here, and his daughter married a radiologist. And he sits at the dinner table and he says, radiology is a very stressful area. He goes, I have to catch these problems. And he said, I can tell it's very difficult work. What is so hard about the work that you do? Describe to me the challenges that you face when you go to read these things. And I mean, I guess the obvious is you don't want to miss a problem. So you carry a huge burden.
Women's imaging, which is what my specialty, what I find most stressful is that I am dealing with a woman's life. You know, if I try to pick up cancers as small as possible, our goal is less than 1 centimeter in size, because the earlier detection, the better their treatment option is and the better that the treatment will work. What is stressful is that, you know, every woman comes in and is nervous about the possibility of having breast cancer. Like we said, it was 1 in 7 women. And it's not to scare women. If you live up to the age of 90, you have a 14% chance of having breast cancer. But remember, you have an 86% chance of not getting breast cancer. So the most stressful part is that, you know, there's so many imaging technologies out there that I want to do what's best for the patient, do every test that I can to help them detect their breast cancer.
Do you personally feel that the digital technology is a better tool?
Definitely. You know, I have grown up in the age where I did do the conventional film screen mammography, and now with the digital mammography, and we pick up so many different things. Microcalcifications, which are little calcium deposits in the breast, are detected so much better now with digital mammography than it used to be. And it's not to say that they're not detected on the conventional way, it's just, it makes it easier for us to see.
It's probably worth mentioning to our viewers that the vast majority of bumps of tissue in a breast are not cancer. They're a benign tumor or calcification or something. So about only 5% of the different tumors would be cancerous? Is that about how it works out?
Most tumors are benign. Okay. You are correct.
And benign means it's not really growing too much and it won't do too much damage, but it's not cancer.
Correct. It is not cancer. When someone says something is benign, that means it is not cancer. Many people come in with pain and lumps, and a majority of the time it is not cancer.
Okay.
A lot of people have... Go ahead.
And if it is cancer in today's world, so let's say that 5% of the bumps in a breast actually might be cancerous, or a little less, right? It's about that amount, I think. But if you catch it early, this is a disease today that can be treated very effectively, and your chances of survival are very, very good, aren't they?
Yes, they are excellent today. There are so many new tests out there that if it is caught early, the chances of survival has significantly increased. And people say that detection of breast cancer, that the prevalence has increased, but you know, in my experience, a lot of the cancers that we pick up are the very early cancers.
For more Medical Matters television shows, go online to
medicalmatters.tv.